This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Leona Mindy Roberts Helmsley, July 4, 1920 to August 20, 2007 was an American businesswoman. She was known for her flamboyant personality and had a reputation for tyrannical behavior that earned her the sobriquet Queen of Mean. She was promoted by the Bieber-Silverstein Group, and its co-founder Joyce Bieber persuaded Helmsley to replace that title for Queen of the Palace Hotel instead after allegations of non-payment by her of contractors hired by her to build her home. Helmsley was investigated and convicted of federal income tax evasion and other crimes in 1989. Although having initially received a sentence of 16 years, Helmsley was required to serve only 19 months in prison and 2 months under house arrest during the trial. A former housekeeper testified that she had heard Helmsley say, "We don't pay taxes, only the little people pay taxes," an aphorism with which she was identified for the rest of her life. Contents 1. Early life. 2. Career as a hotelier. 3. Tax evasion conviction. 4. After prison. 5. Death. 6. The Queen of Mean. 7. References. 71. Notes. 72. Further reading. 8. External links. Early life. Leona Helmsley was born Lena Mindy Rosenthal in Marbletown, New York, to Polish-Jewish immigrants, Ida Nay Popkin, a homemaker, and Morris Rosenthal, a hatmaker. Her family moved to Brooklyn while she was still a girl, and moved 6 more times before settling in Manhattan. She dropped out of Abraham Lincoln High School to seek her fortune in a short time. She changed her name several times, from Lee Roberts, Mindy Roberts, and Lenny Roberts. Eventually, she decided on Leona Mindy Roberts. She legally changed her surname to Roberts. She was a chain smoker, consuming several packs a day. Helmsley would later claim that she appeared in billboard ads for Chesterfield cigarettes, but her claim remains unsubstantiated. Her first husband was attorney Leo Panzierer, whom she divorced in 1952. Their only son was J. 1940-1982, who had 4 children with his wife. Mimi Leona was twice married to and divorced from her second husband, garment industry executive Joseph Lubin. After a brief period at a sewing factory, she joined a New York real estate firm, where she eventually became vice president. Career as a hotelier. Roberts was a real estate salesperson in 1964 when Abe Hirschfeld hired her to sit in the lobby and sell co-ops at 925 Park Avenue in New York. She was a condominium broker in 1968 when she met and began her involvement with the then-married multi-millionaire real estate entrepreneur Harry Helmsley in 1970. She joined one of Helmsley's brokerage firms, Brown, Harris, Stevens, as a senior vice president. At that time, she was already a millionaire in her own right. Helmsley divorced his wife of 33 years and married Roberts on April 8, 1972. Roberts's marriage to Helmsley may well have saved her career. Late in 1971, several of her tenants sued her for forcing the tenants of one of the apartments she managed to buy condominiums. They won, and she was forced not only to compensate the tenants but to give them 3-year leases. Her real estate license was also suspended, so she focused on running Helmsley's growing hotel empire. Leona and Harry B. Helmsley Medical Building, the main building of Greenwich Hospital in Greenwich, Connecticut. Supposedly under her influence, Helmsley began a program of conversion of apartment buildings into condos. He later concentrated on the hotel industry, building the Helmsley Palace on Madison Avenue. Together, the Helmsleys built a real estate empire in New York City, including 230 Park Avenue, the Empire State Building, the Tudor City apartment complex on the east side of Manhattan, and Helmsley Spear, their management and leasing business. The couple also developed properties that included the Park Lane Hotel New York, the New York Helmsley Hotel, the Helmsley Palace Hotel, and hotels in Florida and other states. By the beginning of 1989, 23 hotels in the chain were directly controlled by Leona Helmsley. She was featured in an advertising campaign portraying her as a demanding queen who wanted nothing but the best for her guests. The slightest mistake was usually grounds for firing, and Helmsley was known to shout insults and obscenities at targeted employees just before they were fired. On March 31, 1982, Helmsley's only child, J. Panzierer, died of a heart attack resulting from arrhythmia. Her son's widow, who lived in a property Helmsley owned, received an eviction notice shortly after his funeral. Helmsley successfully sued her son's estate for money and property that she claimed he had borrowed, and she was ultimately awarded $146,092 tax evasion conviction. Despite the Helmsley's tremendous wealth, net worth over a $1 billion, they were known for disputing payments to contractors and vendors. One of these disputes would prove to be their undoing. In 1983, the Helmsleys bought Dunnellan Hall, a 21-room mansion in Greenwich, Connecticut. to use as a weekend retreat. The property cost $11 million, but the Helmsleys wanted to make it even more luxurious. The work included a $1 million dance floor, a silver clock, and a mahogany card table. The remodeling bills came to $8 million, which the Helmsleys were loath to pay. A group of contractors sued the Helmsleys for non-payment. The Helmsleys eventually paid off most of the debt owed to the contractors in 1985. During those proceedings, the contractors revealed that most of their work was being illegally billed to the Helmsleys' hotels as business expenses. The contractors sent a stack of the falsified invoices to the New York Post to prove that the Helmsleys were trying to avoid tax liabilities. The resulting Post story led to a federal criminal investigation. Also, Jeremiah McCarthy, the Helmsleys' executive engineer, alleged that Leona repeatedly demanded that he sign invoices to bill personal expenses to the Helmsley company, and, when McCarthy declined to do so, Helmsley exploded with tyrannical outbursts, shouting, "You're not my fucking partner. You'll sign what I tell you to sign." In 1988, then United States Attorney Rudy Giuliani indicted the Helmsleys and two of their associates on several tax-related charges, as well as extortion. The trial was delayed until the summer of 1989 due to numerous motions by the Helmsleys' attorneys, most of them related to Harry's health. He had begun to appear enfeebled shortly after the beginning of his relationship with Leona Helmsley years before, and had recently suffered a stroke on top of a pre-existing heart condition. Ultimately, he was ruled mentally and physically unfit to stand trial, and Leona would face the charges alone at trial. A former Helmsley Spear executive, Paul Rufino, said that he refused to sign phony invoices billing the company for work done on the Helmsley's Connecticut mansion. Rufino, originally engaged to assist Helmsley through the hospitality management services arm, said that Leona fired him on several different occasions for refusing to sign the bills, but Harry would usually tell him to ignore her and to come back to work. Another one of the key witnesses was a former housekeeper at the Helmsley home, Elizabeth Baum, who recounted Leona Helmsley telling her, "We don't pay taxes, only the little people pay taxes." Helmsley denied saying this by then. However, the trial was already highlighting Helmsley's abusive and micromanaging behavior towards family members as well as employees, contractors, and even senior executives. Helmsley's former employees testified at trial about how they feared her, with one recalling how she casually fired him while she was being fitted for a dress. Most legal observers felt that Helmsley's hostile personality, arrogance, and naked greed alienated the jurors. On August 30, Helmsley was convicted and sentenced of one count of conspiracy to defraud the United States, three counts of tax evasion, three counts of filing false personal tax returns, 16 counts of assisting in the filing of false corporate and partnership tax returns, and 10 counts of mail fraud. She was, however, acquitted of extortion, a charge that could potentially have sent her to prison for the rest of her life. Helmsley was instead sentenced to 16 years in prison, and eventually had that sentence significantly reduced when all but 8 of the convictions were dropped. Nonetheless, when it was clear she was going to prison, Helmsley collapsed outside the courthouse. She was later diagnosed with a heart irregularity and hypertension. Helmsley's new lawyer, retained to appeal the judgment, was Alan Dershowitz. Following the appeal, which resulted in a reduced sentence, she was ordered to report to prison on tax day, April 15, 1992. Her Federal Bureau of Prisons BOP register number was 15113054, and she was released from BOP custody on January 26, 1994, after serving 19 months after prison. Helmsley's later years were apparently spent in isolation, especially after Harry died in 1997. He left her his entire fortune, including the Helmsley Hotels, the Helmsley Palace, and the Empire State Building, estimated to be worth well in excess of $5 billion. Her few friends included Patrick Ward, Imelda Marcos, Rodrigo Handal, the Noriega family, and Kathy and Rick Hilton. A 2001 Chicago Sun-Times article depicted her as estranged from her grandchildren and with few friends, living alone in a lavish apartment with her dog. In 2002, Helmsley was sued by Charles Bell, a former employee who alleged that he was discharged solely for being gay. A jury agreed and ordered Mrs. Helmsley to pay Bell $11,200,000 in damages. A judge subsequently reduced this amount to $554,000. She was forced to give up control of her hotel empire, since most of her hotels had bars and New York does not allow convicted felons to hold alcohol licenses. Mrs. Helmsley lived her final year at her penthouse atop the Park Lane Hotel. Although Helmsley had a reputation as the Queen of Mean, some considered her generous in her charitable charitable contributions after her prison term after September 11, 2001, Helmsley donated $5 million to help the families of New York City firefighters. Other contributions included $25 million to New York Presbyterian Hospital for medical research. Death. Leona Helmsley died from congestive heart failure at the age of 87, on August 20, 2007, at Dunnellan Hall, her summer home in Greenwich, Connecticut. Cardiovascular disease ran in her family, claiming the lives of her father, son and a sister. After a week at the Frank E. Campbell Funeral Chapel, she was entombed next to Harry Helmsley in a mausoleum constructed for $14. Helmsley left the bulk of her estate, estimated at more than $4.5 billion.